before our day, the wolf of hunger clawed each door. Full many did not own a bed, but slept upon the earthen floor. The year had not supplied the rain to make the corn and cotton grow. Waste not or want will be our lot. These were words that all would know. Poor gentle Anna May was caught in that web of hungry pain. She did not waste a shrunken brood or one small cob of cherished grain. She washed and mended faithfully the faded dress she daily wore. Rainless days went sadly by, more hot and humid than before. Oft late at night, when hours seemed cool, she'd wash her tired, dusty face, take up her old stiff cornhusk broom, and sweep around the cabin place. She'd stand a while on the porch and gaze about the silver moon, reflecting as she swept the boards, and praying rain would come real soon. It was a time of strange beliefs that marred the minds of that sad day. Men dwelt on powers of witchery, and threw their common sense away. One man who owned a tract of land and sought to conquer acres more was such, and on his homeward way he rode one night past Anna's door. He stood his horse in musing thought. To him it seemed an eerie sight. Only a witch would ply a broom alone and go so late at night. The next day, when he told his tale, he found listeners quite a few. They quickly planned to go that night to see if it was really true. Safe hidden by the bushy growth, they waited for the moon to rise. They saw the sweeper with her broom, a witch indeed before their eyes. Come down, sweet cleansing rain, come down and make the corn and cotton grow. These were her oft repeated words before they turned in haste to go. And as they hurried on their way, thinking a witch's curse, she said, they felt the long-desired rain come falling softly on each head. She is indeed a witch, they cried, more vengeful than they were before. We saw her broom, we heard her words, we need not ponder anymore. For if she can cause the rain to fall, what else can such a creature do? She'll take our houses and our land, destroy us all before she's through. They came, stout minions of the law, and took poor gentle Anna May down to the village shrine court to hear the judge and people say. She has been seen by many men, a corn husk broom held in her hand, sweeping destruction from the sky to fall upon our cherished land. They did not hear her gentle voice saying she only prayed for care. They did not see a frightened maid. They saw a witch they knew was there, so they burned her at the fiery stake. How can such sin from men be shriven? The law did plainly state and say that was a fate to witches given. Those are the times from which we come to find a wiser path to tread. Those are the deeds we can't forget that lie so heavy on each head. For sad to say, there still are those who seek new witches they might slay. They harbor cankers in their breast that gnaw their bitter parts away. Perhaps in some deep testing hour they'll hear the truth in Anna's prayer. Fall softly, sweetly, cleansing rain. Some thirsty hearts still need